It's my pleasure to introduce to you Marcelo Paiva. He's a product design director and educator from Miami. He has spent over 15 plus years designing teams, solving complex problems, developing expertise to foster modern design practices for mobile and web apps. His extensive leadership with designers and front-end developers has been enabling a creative environment for colleagues and other team members. So, can we have on stage Mr. Paiva?
Thank you. So we're setting up the computer there, but we're going to do a play here. You know how in soccer games, they do the wave? They go like, yay, and everyone comes like this way? Well, let's do different. Let's start clapping from the back. And the moment you hear the person right next to you clapping behind your back, you clap. And let's see how it gets over here, and then I'll clap back to you guys. You want to do that? You, the last person over there, do one clap, like, very loud. See how it got much stronger here? It started very slow, okay? Now let's try to clap very strong from here, because we're gonna win. This side's gonna win, all right? I'm gonna help you. They're all sleeping back there. What I'm gonna show to you here is everything. I'm gonna share all my failures. And that's why every talk I give, I show this picture first. Because that's what makes you grow. Every time you go, you fall, and you come back up, that's how you become better. The same way we start clapping from behind, very slowly, and it became stronger here, is because someone that heard you clapping learned how to clap, and you got much stronger here. That's the way I see knowledge. And I changed my talk from impacting organizations. This is the title that I gave to Bapu, impacting organizations through the proper design practice education. And then I changed this to impacting lives and business through proper knowledge sharing. And this is what I think it's missing in a design community. So we need to share our knowledge. And I think that would solve a lot of the problems that we were just talking about between industry and academia. And I'll talk to that later on, because I was listening to them talking, I was changing my slides. Just a quick note, my name is Marcelo Paiva. I am the founder of Pixel Blocks. I just founded this company right here, right now, 5 minutes ago. And so I think the idea is to use UX design, accelerate your careers. That's what I'm trying to do. So I spent many years in Boston, New York, Wall Street, and then my son went to college. And I said, this is a perfect time for me to go to Florida. So I went to Miami, where I met Apurv. And I decided to leave everything behind that I learned throughout the years, building teams, being a designer, and building teams, how to become more efficient, designing, working with the developers, working with the QA, the lady just asked that earlier. Right, working as a cross-functional team to understand how to accelerate design solutions properly. So I was given like 18 minutes to talk. I have about 25 slides, so I'm gonna have to try to keep fast. But for those doing the Twitter thing, my handle is Muqueca. It's a seafood dish in Brazil. I am Brazilian. And I grew up with all the issues that you're having over here. That's why I'm so passionate and so humbled to be here in India and seeing the same problems that I'm seeing you facing when I was growing up. So that's very interesting to me. It's kind of a nostalgic moment. And the hashtag UXINDIA16, do that. Let's make this happen. This is a community that we need to grow. Okay, here's the question. Have I impacted any life here in the room? If so, raise your hand. I know I won't have many, so there's one there. There's a guy walking on, looking at the computer, and he's just raising his hand. Okay, so only one. Oh, there's another person there. Thank you. Not sure how I impacted, but this is good. By the end of this talk, I want to impact each and every one of you, okay? The first time, I think I'm going to skip this slide. So you know the impact is a font typeface created by Jeffrey Lee in 1963. And that was the first thing that came to my mind when Bapu gave me, oh, impact by design. Yes, impact, the typography, right? And that's the first thing, literally, that's the first thing that came to my mind. And but just to give the proper credit, Jeffrey Lee, he created this typeface in metal. He had to carve in a metal typeface. And, you know, today is the most used fonts in the memes, on the memes. So that's, yeah. When you see all the cats smiling, that's that font. Okay, but when he created this typography, his goal was to impact as many people as possible. Think about this. He created this typeface for a newspaper in London. And what he did is, well, I need to put as much ink as possible. Sorry, man. Thank you. So I need to create a typeface that will use as much ink as possible. You can, you know, you can Google for impact, but I think what's good to mention is just like a public service. So, I don't know, I think I need to go over here. Okay, isn't that what we're trying to do? We're trying to impact people's lives, being a designer. And that's why I thought, no, I'm not going to remove those slides. I'm going to keep it because that's exactly what we're trying to do. Anything we do, we try to impact people's lives. It's kind of cool that there's a mirror over there. So I change over here, I can actually read backwards. And so yeah, that's what we're trying. Now, this is a list that I exported from LinkedIn yesterday. I don't have a formal design background. I grew up as a designer. I'm going to show you my career graph later on, and you see how I became a designer. But I'm not sure how many professors or teachers takes to create a designer. But I can tell you, it took me over 900 people. To me, this is my school, right? 900 people. You can probably find Bapu here somewhere. I think there's a, oh, there you go. There, you know, the first one, my parents, obviously. I had to put my parents there. There's, these are people that, that actually impacted my life. Each one of these person here, you know, they always taught me something, positively and negatively. So even the negative moments that I have had with these people, it made me better. So this is the way I see school. For each one of you, I encourage you, go to school, do the proper background, and then become a leader, right? Understand how to work with one another. That's your school. I'll get to that in a second. But I just want to mention two people that I met this morning and that had impacted my life. Paritosh Shiber, is he here? He's right back there. So Paritosh, he is actually building a prototyping tool, a product for designers. So he's doing a service to the community, and it's open source, it's free. So I'm willing to help him to push the idea forward. And I'm starting now, I'm broadcasting to plugging what he's doing because it's a good service. He's taking care of the community. The other person is Narsing Rao Bungurala. This guy is amazing. And he handles accessibility foundation. And we were talking about what I was going to talk about, knowledge sharing. And he came to me, and the first thing I asked him, he was driving his Rolls Royce there, and towards to me and say, how do you find accessibility here in a hotel? And this guy came up to me, yeah, actually, I have an accessibility foundation. I found it very difficult. And he started talking about accessibility. And that's great. That's how we impact people, right? He impacted me, and he's on my list. By the end of this talk, I would love to feel this space here with your names. Come talk to me. Let's, come up with something. Should we clap again? Are you guys up? From here? Let's do the clap wave. We just came up with a term. See, UX India came up with a term. Clap wave from the back. I like it. Let's clap back, folks. Come on. So this is me. This is how I see myself today. And those people, the 900 people, they impact me to become this graph. And this graph is, if this thing works, that's my career graph. This is me. So I started in 1986 at GE in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. And I started as hand drafter. So actually I did hand drafting on a drawing board. We used to do high voltage control panels for GE. And I was only 19 years old. And I didn't have the privilege and the financial means to go to college. So I had to come up with something. So since I was only 19 years old, and that was right at the year that they start putting 286s on our department. And the old guys say, hey, you're the youngest guy. Go play with the computer. So I did. And I stopped playing with AutoCAD for DOS. And I start learning Lisp in AutoCAD. And next thing I know, I was redrawing all the forms that they used to have, that we used to draw by hand. I was just recreating the forms in AutoCAD and printing them and creating a bunch of copies. And these guys were like, how did you do that so fast? So that was the opportunity I took. That led me to desktop publishing over the years, and then desktop application design, user interface design, and obviously the web, now mobile, and I think the next thing will be invisible. It will be sharing knowledge. To me, it will be invisible. It could be invisible both ways, right? There's a talk here, there was a talk here. Is that 5 minutes that I have left? Okay, I'm gonna push forward here. But this is me. And how do we do this? What do we do, and how do we impact people? I'm going to go this way here. So if you guys are familiar with the Maslow's hierarchy of needs, we have the basic layer is physiological, and then as you grow, you become more confident, and you have the safety layer. And as you continue to grow, you start interacting with your family, with your friends, and you have a sense of community. as you grow older and get more mature, you gain self-esteem and you start respecting and be respected by others. And the top one on the pyramid is the self-actualization, the spontaneity. So in UX, it's the same thing. You as designer, when you first go in the industry after you graduate, you depend on people. You learn how to do things by people teaching you how to do it. So you go through the same phase. The second step is that you feel confident and start working independently. The third step is when you start working with your teams. And this is where I think I kind of disagree with the discussion that we had on a panel first. I think the best school that designers can have is your team. So you learn from each other, right? And one of the things that I built many design teams before. If I can count, it would be about six. And the latest one was a true cross-functional. It was my first opportunity to build a cross-functional team with developers and product managers, designers. Small, lean team, and they all collaborated together. But the key thing is that someone mentioned here, it's not about creating designers. It's, as a leader, you need to create leaders. It's not a matter of creating senior designers. You need to create leaders. So if you have the opportunity as a manager, don't try to limit the designer, the junior designer. See the junior designer, the leader that you are today, because that's what you're teaching them. The fourth one, you start mentoring the junior folks, right? And you can see how the Maslow's hierarchy of needs, it's very related to what we're talking about in our career. And finally, as I see when a designer becomes, it gets to a level that it's, it cares enough about sharing knowledge, they start speaking publicly. If it's not publicly, externally, they will speak public pitching to the stakeholders, right? It takes courage, it takes experience to do that. So you can go both ways. If you are shy, you have to learn how to speak design. You know, the least you have to learn how to sell your ideas to your stakeholders. But if you really care, you can share your knowledge with the community. And that's one of the things that I'm trying to do here while I'm in India. On Sunday, I'm going to Delhi. I'm starting the first meetup for the Interaction Design Association chapter in Delhi. So I would encourage you guys from Hyderabad to do the same. We don't have a IXDA chapter in Hyderabad. If you want to start a new interaction design chapter here, come talk to me and I can help. I'm in a committee in Miami, in Gurgaon, and now I would love to help you here. So this is where we are today, right? The current world situation is very egocentric. We hide our weaknesses. We procrastinate giving. We always think that, oh, I want to become successful because I can before I can start giving back to the community. And a bald guy once said that success is how you feel inside. You can fake it. You can show success to other people, but the way you really feel will tell you if you are successful. You can clap, come on. Come on, let's practice again. Clap wave. Let's do a clap hurricane now. Earthquake. You know, the bald guy also said, in product design, success is knowledge sharing. And that's the way I want to impact you today. If you really want to make your career grow, share your knowledge. Share your knowledge. Don't be shy. Don't be selfish. don't be protective, because the way you share, someone's going to share back to you, and you're going to learn something. And I would assume, let's the quick raise hands. Just two more minutes, okay? Can you raise your hand if you are already working in a team environment? Are you a team member? Okay. So all of you, you're already here on three. Okay? Is anyone on four already? Mentoring people? You see how you are? You're ready. You are definitely ready. So I had a dream. Literally, I had a dream about a week ago. And I think the dream that I had, I was talking to you guys, and I had to impact these people. I need to invite them to do something with me. And this is by no means, is like, I'm not trying to start a company here. I'm really trying to build a community. And I give a lot of credit to Bapu and all the volunteers here, because the amount of work that it takes to put this thing together is amazing. I've been coordinating with him for months about my trip alone, just my trip. But, you know, can you imagine how long it takes to build all these things, to coordinate all these things? So I want to invite you, I want to invite you to impact people's lives together with me, all right? I put together this UX for Life. When I had the dream, I went on and I just quickly, I bought that domain and I just created a Slack channel. And that's how I want to propose this to you. Go to this link, sign up. It's simple enough for you to remember. It's ux4.life. And you're going to get a form with those with that tagline in there. And then we are going to create... Who's using Slack here yet? Okay, so pretty much a lot of people are already using Slack. So we can create Slack to build the UX India community. And the goal is, the goal is for us to come up, converse on Slack, come up with a project, and 1 year from now, on the next UX India, if I'm not speaking, I'll come eat the biryani chicken. Delicious, right? So, and present what we have put together. I'm offering you this. I don't have much to offer, but I know how to build teams, and I'm very confident that I have a lot of talent over here. And that's why I'm in India, because I see a lot of talented people here. And we see India in the US as the IT country. And it's not true. Go to Dribbble. You see a lot of Indian designers, talented designers, building amazing interfaces, amazing user experiences. And most of them are here. So let me help you, and you can help me become a better person. Thank you very much.